This is a Friday Shoes production. The lesson is 2-7 on page 119 in our book. The target is I can solve equations with rational numbers. What's nice about this is we've actually already solved problems like this, one-step equations, when we just had integers. Now we're dealing with the vast rational numbers, which include all the decimals to the right of the decimal point and any fractions. So let's take a look. It's going to be very similar to what you've done before, and we're going to follow those same steps. So let's try number one. It says solve p minus 7.36 equals 2.84. Well, I'm going to rewrite the problem a little bit closer to the middle here. Once we have that problem written down, of course, I'm going to create my train tracks. I'm going to solve for p. I want to get p by itself. I want to isolate the variable. What did they do to the p? Well, they subtracted 7.36 from it. So to get back to what p is, we have to do the inverse operation of subtracting 7.36, and that would be adding 7.36 to both sides. When you do that, of course, that will go down to zero, leaving the p left over. And that's going to be equal to whatever 2.84 plus 7.36 is. So we have 0 here plus the 1 there. We got 2 plus the 1 there. We've got ourselves 10. So we've got 10.20. That is our answer. You can go ahead and check that if you want on your calculator. 10.2 minus 7.36 does equal 2.84. How about number 2 here? It says solve 1 half is equal to t plus 3 fourths. So something plus 3 fourths is equal to 1 half. A lot of students like to rewrite this so that the letter is on the left side. If you do, just keep everything nice and neat. In this case, again, we're going to draw down our train tracks to keep our left side from our right side. And then we're going to try to isolate the variable t by itself. We're going to do the inverse of adding 3/4, which would be, of course, subtracting 3/4. And we have to do that on both sides. When we do that, 3/4 minus 3/4 disappears to zero. We bring down our t that's left over on this side, and we have t equals whatever a half minus 3/4 is. Well, I remember having to, when we add or subtract, we have to have the common denominator. So I have to multiply this by 2, and now we'll have 2/4 minus the 3/4. What is 2/4 minus 3/4? That's negative 1/4. That's 2 minus 3 on top, and then the 4 stays on the bottom. So the answer would be t is equal to negative 1/4. Go ahead and plug that in there, and you'll notice that negative 1/4 plus 3/4 does equal 2/4, which you can reduce down to 1/2. All right, you give it a shot. Pause the video. Try these three. Come on back when you have your answers. Step 1. Draw your train tracks. Step 2, inverse operation to get t by itself. You'd add 7.81. This would cancel out to 0. So t is equal to whatever this problem is right here. So we have 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 plus 8 is 11. Carry the 1 over there. 4, 7 is 11. Plus 1 is 12. So we have 12.13. Go ahead and check that on a calculator for yourself, and it does check. Happy check. All right, second one here. Same thing, draw our train tracks, keep our middle organized, and we have our left and right side. Do the inverse operation, which is subtracting 2/5. When I do that, I have y left over here, and that's equal to negative 1/2 minus 2/5. Let me write that down here. Negative 1/2 minus 2/5. Well, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to change that minus into adding the opposite, so I'm going to have the negative 2 on the top and a plus now. Now 2 and 5, what is the common denominator? That's 10. How do I change a 10? All right, 2 into a 10, multiply by 5, so I got to take the top times 5. So the top will be negative 5. And then the other one, 5 over here, how do I change that into a 10? I multiply that by 2. So I multiply the top by 2, and I got negative 4. When I add those together, I do have negative 9/10. That is the answer, negative 9/10. All right, this one here, 1 and 5/6 is equal to 2 and 1/3 plus a. All right, I'm going to flip this around so that we have the a on the other side. Now, you can do this because of the commutative property, which we discussed. First of all, it's reflexive, meaning we can just flip everything around, but then I actually switch these two positions because adding is commutative. You can switch it, it's not going to change the math behind it. All right, so now we have something plus 2 and a third is equal to 1 and 5/6. Well, do the inverse operation. Subtract 2 and 1/3 from both sides. This will go down to 0, and you're left with a over on the left side. And then whatever 1 and 5/6 minus 2 and 1/3 is equal to. Now this one gets a little, when you have mixed numbers, we know this can be confusing. So what I like to do is change these into improper fractions. So 6 times 1 plus 5 is going to be 11/6. And then 3 times 2 plus 1 is going to be 7/3, but with a minus on it. So I have 11/6 minus 7/3. Now I know that the common denominator is going to be 6 because 3 does go into 6. So I'm going to change this 3 into a 6. And by doing so, I'll have to change the top because I multiply this by 2 to get to the 6. Multiply the top by 2 to get to a 14. So I have 14/6. Now that looks kind of ugly, so I'll kind of erase that and really show you what's happening here. So I'd have 11/6 minus 14/6. I think you could do that. We take our 11 minus the 14, and we get our -3/6. And that reduces down to -1/2, because you divide both those by 3. So the answer is -1/2. All right, let's take a look at solving by using multiplication or division. Now we have these multiplication and division problems. Well, we got 4/7 b is equal to 16. What do we want to do here? This is the part where we've got to use our reciprocals or our multiplicative inverse to solve. Now, what have we been taught in the past? Well, whatever's in front of this b, we want to divide by it. For instance, if you remember, let me do a simple problem for you. 3 times something equals 15. We all know it's 5. What do we do, though, to get that? We divide both sides by 3. Okay, so a lot of people will say, hey, divide this side by 4/7 and divide this side by 4/7. Well, that does work. But remember, when we divide, we actually multiply by its multiplicative inverse. So instead of taking 4/7 and dividing by 4/7, we actually will do this. We're going to multiply both sides by 7/4. When we do that, the same thing as dividing by 4/7. So what happens on the left side? Left side, well, 7 times 4 is 28, and 4 times 7 is 28. So it's 28 over 28, which really is just 1b. So we just have 1b. They actually, you might call it canceling out. It actually becomes 1, but we just have 1b there sitting there by itself. On the right side, we're going to change this into a fraction, and then we're going to cancel out or reduce if we can. And I know that 4 goes into itself one time and it goes into 16 four times. That's nice because now we have 4 times 7 on top, that's 28. We have 1 times 1 on the bottom, that's 1. And we know that 28 divided by 1 is just 28. There's our final answer. Take a look at one of these here. Solve 58.4 equals negative 7.3. Times something. Well, step one, draw our lines down. Step two is undo what they did on this side. Now let me rewrite the math problem. I'm going to rewrite it so that we have the m on this side over here, which a lot of people like to do. That's called the reflexive property. You can flip that around, everything's okay. Now again, we took this m right here, and we multiplied it by 7.3. So we have to undo it by dividing by negative 7.3. So we divide both sides by negative 7.3. This will cancel down with to m because it becomes 1. And then how many negative 7.3 is going to 58.4? We got a negative, a positive divided by a negative, which I know the answer is going to be negative. And then I have to figure out how many 7.3s go in there. Well, I'm going to take a guess here. 7 times 7 is 49. 7 times 8 is 56. I'm going to take 7.3 times 8, because that's close to 56. See what happens. There's 4, carry the 2. 8 times 7 is 56, plus the 2 is 58. One decimal. There it is. So actually, it does go in there exactly 8 times. This will actually work out to this. So it's 8 times. Don't forget it was negative, so there you are. M is negative 8. Be nice if you had a calculator to use. Try these two. All right, so 7.2 times V is equal to negative 36. Simply undo it by dividing by 7.2. My fraction bar represents division. 7.2 divided by 7.2 is 1V, meaning in your world they cancel out and it's left with V. And then you take negative 36 divided by 7.2. I know that's going to be a negative answer because negative divided by a positive is a negative. 36 divided by 7.2. How many 7.2s go into 36? All right, I'm just estimating in my head. 7 times 5 is 35, so I'm going to guess 5. 7.2 times 5, I'm doing this over on the side here, that's 36. One decimal spot. So it's 36 exactly. So it does go in there exactly 5 times. So the answer will be negative 5 just because of the negative divided by positive. All right, here we are, negative 2/3 times n is equal to negative 3/5. Again, most people say, well, do the inverse of multiplying by negative 2/3 and divide by negative 2/3. But you remember, keep, change, flip. If you're going to do that, you have to keep the first, and then you change this division into multiplication, and then you flip the fraction. So it's actually going to be negative 3 over 2. That's what I'm going to multiply both sides by. All you have to remember is flip the fraction and multiply it on both sides. That's really what you're going to end up doing. What happens then is these will cancel out, and you're left with n. And now you got two negatives being multiplied, so I know that the answer is going to be positive. And I don't see anything that can cancel out, so I just do the tops. 3 times 3, which is 9, and then 5 times 2, which is 10. So the answer is going to be 9/10. All right, this last one. Check it out, soccer. It says in 2006, the World Cup was won by Italy. They defeated France 6-4 in the shootout. Actually, I'm not looking at that. Little known fact, in 1986, Mr. Lentz played on the Maroon Italian Soccer Club in Chicago. That was a World Cup year, too. I think Argentina won that year. And Maradona was a famous soccer player who had a very unique style of actually scoring a goal. He used his hand. It's one of the, they call it one of the best goals ever. So if you ever want to Google something, check that out. Here, number 5, it says, during practice, a soccer player completed 18 goals, which were 9 of 25 of his goal attempts, or 9/25 of his goal attempts. Write and solve an equation to determine his goal attempts at that practice. Well, if you take a look, they break it out for you. You're looking for 9/25 of the goal attempts, and that's going to be 18. So they tell you G is going to be the goal attempts. Then you multiply that by the 9/25, and that's got to equal 18. Then they go ahead and solve it for you. Notice how they're multiplying by the reciprocal, or the flip of the fraction. And they do the math for you in their heads here, and they say that's 50. So the soccer player had 50 goal attempts, and he made 9/25 of those. Try this one. Larissa pays $0.25 or 25 cents per minute for long distance calls on her cell phone. Her long distance charge last month was $5. Write and solve an equation that could be used to determine the number of minutes she used to make long distance calls. Well, let's see here. She is calling and charged 25 cents per minute. So I would say for 1 minute, it would be 25 cents. If I put 2 in for M, I'm going to use M for a minute. Then it would be 50 cents. If she had 3 minutes, 3 times 0.25 would be 75 cents. And she spent, it looks like, $5. Now they go out two decimal spots here, so I'm going to put in two decimal spots. So it's $5 right there. There it is. There's the equation they're looking for. And then, of course, to solve that one, all you do is you would divide by 0.25 on both sides. And then M would equal whatever this is. This cancels out. And how many 25 cents make up $5? Well, there's four in each dollar, and there's $5. So it's 20 of them. So 20, that will be your minutes. For every minute, it costs 25 cents. So she was on the phone for 20 minutes. Don't forget, you can always review these videos. And, of course, the examples are in the book. Or check out the personal tutor videos on the online textbook. This has been a Friday Shoes production.